8 Tips for Effective Bar Exam Review in the Philippines from the first CPA lawyer of the Bugcalid Indigenous Cultural Community, Indigenous People, ICC, IP, Attorney Efraim Osingat, CPA, MBA.
If you like this type of content, be sure to follow this channel. Do not forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel called Thelawrequisites.
Just to pass the bar, I did everything within my power to make it. With God's help and guidance, I was able to pass the bar on my first take. No one can dictate to you how you do your own bar review, but allow me to share what I did that might help you in your review for the bar exams.
1. Make a bar review schedule.
Make sure that by now you should have your own schedule. To make a schedule, consider the subjects with heaviest weight or rate of percentage. As a concept, allocate more time to heavier subjects like the subjects remedial law and civil law. You must follow this schedule at all costs so that you will feel confident and that you will not fear the fast approaching bar examination date.
2. Know what type of learner you are, i.e. visual, reader, listener.
As for me, I only recall what I read during the bar review. I had hard time recalling the lectures of the bar reviewers during review. What I recalled are concepts from my under-law discussion. What helped me recall what I read during the bar exam was by using the read aloud function of Microsoft Word. My procedure is to convert my PDF reviewers into Word file, then read them aloud using the Microsoft application in my laptop, iPod, and sometimes to my cell phone.
3. Know the ALAC method of answering bar exam question.
ALAC is an acronym which means
A for answer either yes or no question,
L for give the legal basis for your answer,
A means apply the law in the given problem,
C means make a conclusion.
If you are familiar with this method during your law schooling, then answering the bar will be easier for you. Just remember ALAC when answering and you will surely pass the bar examinations. Just study your law, be familiar with it. To give an example of a bar exam question that is answered using the ALAC method.
Question. Plaintiff filed a case of forcible entry in MCTC against the defendant who has been occupying the former's land for more than 1 year. Is the action tenable? Using the ALAC method, this will be the answer.
A for no, the action is not tenable. L for under the Section 1 of Rule 70 of the Revised Rules of Civil Procedure provides MCTC has jurisdiction over forcible entry cases that is filed within 1 year after such unlawful deprivation or withholding of possession. A for in the case at bar, the plaintiff filed the forcible entry case at MCTC only after 1 year of the occupation of the defendant. C for hence, the action is not tenable. The plaintiff should have filed the same at the regional trial court for Acción Publiciana.
To consolidate as a bar exam answer, here is the answer. No, the action is not tenable. Under the Section 1 of Rule 70 of the Revised Rules of Civil Procedure provides MCTC has jurisdiction over forcible entry cases that is filed within 1 year after such unlawful deprivation or withholding of possession. In the case at bar, the plaintiff filed the forcible entry case at MCTC only after 1 year of the occupation of the defendant. Hence, the action is not tenable. The plaintiff should have filed the same at the regional trial court for Acción Publiciana.
Four. Compile all relevant provisions of law given in the bar syllabus.
Upon releasing the bar syllabus, I already downloaded the relevant laws and I tried to read it from time to time. I also made audio codals out of these laws so I can listen to it every time I had a chance. I listen to the codals when I am driving and performing house chores.
5. Have a reading sequence.
Read the law, then the jurisprudence based on your bar review schedule, bar examination questions, quamto, review center reviewer give priority in your review the provisions of the substantive law, meaning the provisions of the new civil code, revised rules of court among others. Read only those which are mentioned in the bar syllabus, because the bar examinations will not ask question that is not present in the bar syllabus. Read likewise the jurisprudence within the cutoff provided for by the bar syllabus. It will likewise help you if you read the previous bar exam questions to acquaint you with the manner of creation of bar exam questions.
6. Quality over quantity, set a daily reading target.
You need not compare your bar review with your fellow reviewees, because it does not help. Every bar reviewee has its own pace. Some may read at least 5 times, some can only read twice yet still manage to pass the bar exams.
7. Rest, you need it.
As your kuya who managed to pass the bar ahead of you, let me remind you that your life is more important than passing the bar exams. Nothing is more important than your safety and longevity. Hence, please rest, sleep at least 6 hours and eat healthy foods. Do not make the same mistake that I did. I only slept 3 to 4 hours a day, studied at least 15 hours per day and consumed at least 4 liters of Coke per week that resulted to my being diagnosed with pre-diabetic condition. Due to extreme stress and anxiety, I had continuous nosebleeding incidents even during the actual bar examinations that hindered me in answering the bar exams.
8. Above all, do not forget to pray for guidance. This helped me.
You must remind yourself that being a barrister is already an achievement. Do not lose confidence. You are already an achiever. You are a double degree holder or more for some intellectuals. You just need to take the bar exams to formalize your being a lawyer. The road is difficult but is doable. You can do it. If you like this type of content, be sure to follow this channel. Do not forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel called Thelawrequisites.ph. Take care always.